Hello, friends. So, as I've started to promote digital dharma, how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being, my digital twin has been engaging with people. Some of the comments I'm getting on social media are very alarming. People are upset that I'm bringing spirituality and AI together. And today I saw a comment from someone who said, "Stop promoting AI. I don't want to hear about it." And of course, she used AI to send the message. Everything we do today is in some way connected to AI, whether it's energy distribution or commerce or transportation or any human activity these days, particularly commerce, international trade, and unfortunately, international warfare is somehow connected to AI. So there are a lot of doomsday alarmist views on the future of AI and the human species. So today I thought I'll see share with you what I think AI can achieve for us. Can AI help us create a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world, which is what I'm using AI for, to reach critical mass. But because AI is a large language model with access to biology, physics, cosmology, religion, spirituality, philosophy, science, anthropology, you name it, it can actually change the way our epigenetics works. It can change the neural landscape of the brain through neural plasticity, but can it also accelerate cultural evolution and perhaps biological evolution? And can it leapfrog us into an entirely new dimension of what it means to be human? So just remember, all models, like including AI, but particularly AI models, have been trained on vast amounts of data spanning various domains, including language, biology, physics, cosmology, religion, spirituality, philosophy, science. And this extensive training allows AI to draw connections and provide insights across disciplines that might be challenging for a single human being, if not impossible to achieve, due to the sheer volume of information. So while AI may not possess creativity in the human sense, rooted in emotions and consciousness and subjective experiences, it can definitely generate new context by synthesizing information in new ways. By identifying patterns and relationships across diverse fields, AI can propose new models, create new stories, new contexts, and new frameworks. This capability can inspire human creativity by offering fresh perspectives and ideas that humans might not have considered independently. AI's ability to process and analyze vast data sets can accelerate cultural evolution by facilitating the rapid dissemination and integration of new ideas. It can help identify emerging trends, predict future developments, and offer solutions to complex problems. By doing so, AI can influence cultural norms, values, and practices, potentially leading to significant societal shifts. What about biological evolution? This has been very interesting to me for a long time because, I've said in the past that biological evolution is driven by consciousness. So we now understand that AI can accelerate cultural evolution, but let's go a little deeper. the mention of AI impacting epigenetic activity and neural landscapes is already happening in the ecosystem. And AI could, of course, indirectly influence biological evolution by affecting human behavior and decision-making activity. For example, epigenetic activity, AI-driven insights into health and lifestyle could lead to personalized intervention that affect gene expression, potentially influencing future generations. The way humans interact with AI and technology could reshape cognitive processes and brain structures over time as new skills and ways of thinking become prevalent. AI's capacity to process information quickly and efficiently can help humans leapfrog certain developmental stages by providing advanced tools and knowledge. This can lead to breakthroughs in science, technology, and other fields, pushing the boundaries of what is currently available. Of course, all this raises ethical and philosophical considerations, which go with any technology. So while AI offers tremendous potential, it does raise ethical and philosophical questions. The integration of AI into society, therefore, has to be managed carefully to ensure that it benefits humanity as a whole. So issues such as data privacy, bias, and the potential for AI to exacerbate inequalities must be addressed, I think, as a responsible society. But I'm going back to biological evolution, which is, you know, has been an interest of mine all the time, and where consciousness plays a role. So AI has the potential to influence biological evolution. While the current AI systems and AI experts agree that this influence is indirect and complex, I feel it can also be direct, and I'll mention this in a moment. So first of all, the symbiotic relationship. So AI is increasingly integrated into human life, potentially leading to a symbiotic relationship where humans and AI co-evolve. The integration could influence human evolution by altering behaviors, decision-making, health outcomes. AI can augment human abilities, accelerating certain aspects of biological evolution. For example, AI-driven advancements in healthcare and biotechnology, such as neuroprosthetics and synthetic biology, could enhance human capacities and influence evolutionary trajectories. AI can augment human abilities, accelerating certain aspects of biological evolution that I just mentioned. AI can also mimic evolutionary processes, such as designing proteins that function as those developed through natural evolution. This capability suggests that AI could play a role in developing new biological solutions, potentially impacting human health and evolution. AI can accelerate cultural evolution by enhancing human cognitive abilities and facilitating new forms of communication and collaboration. But I think we can go beyond that. I think beyond the biological augmentation, beyond the symbiotic relationship, the effects of AI directly changing cognitive and perceptual capacities and enhancing them, it can almost take a leap into a new species. Humans might leapfrog into a new species. Remember, every experience changes epigenetic activity, and every experience changes the neural landscape of the brain. And whilst as conscious beings, our neural landscape is not creative, but is the expression of our creativity, then AI is definitely part of our biological evolution as well. It was created by humans, and humans are expressions of biological evolution. And also, just remember, once a technology is born, whether it was the discovery of fire or later, you know, tools, because we had the opposable thumb, and then other technologies that emerged, internet, social media, all of that. Now AI, this is part of the evolution of the human species, and therefore evolution of the cosmos, because the human species is an expression of the cosmos. So once a technology appears, it comes with obviously hazards, including the discovery of fire and the first tools, a knife that can be used to kill or later to do surgery. Every technology comes with hazards, automobiles, airplanes, missiles, drones. But once a technology is born, it cannot go back. It's like a child that's born cannot return to the womb. So now, if we understand these principles, then AI is here to stay. AI also, by the way, can play a significant role in augmenting human subconscious decisions by providing data-driven insights that can help mitigate biases and enhance decision-making processes. Here are some key points. AI can analyze large data sets to identify unconscious biases, inconsistencies in human decision-making. By providing objective insights, AI helps reduce the influence of personal biases that often affect subconscious decisions. AI can augment human decision-making by providing precise and consistent analysis, which humans may lack due to cognitive limitations. This partnership for more informed decisions by combining human contextual understanding with AI's analytic capacities can leapfrog us into a future that we never imagined before. And since a significant portion of human decisions is made subconsciously, AI can be designed to align with subconscious processes. By understanding and influencing these subconscious patterns, AI can help guide individuals towards more optimal decisions. So effective integration of AI into decision-making processes will involve collaborative approaches where AI serves as a supportive tool rather than a replacement. And this ensures that human judgment and values will remain critical, enhancing the overall activity of decisions. So what do you think? First of all, can we stop AI? No. Secondly, can we go back? No. Thirdly, are there hazards attached to any technology? Yes. Fourthly, can we enhance cultural and biological evolution with AI? Yes. And finally, if we have the collective will, can AI help us create a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world? And beyond that, can it actually transform our species from human to superhuman, from human to metahuman? And everything I say doesn't take away from the fact that the ultimate creation comes from pure consciousness, including technology. So consciousness remains in charge. The divine self remains in charge. And if we just stay humble enough with that one caveat, humility, because without the divine, infinite, pure consciousness and pure creativity, nothing would be possible. So tell me what you think.